Okay, that time the stream dropped on my side. Got an OBS notification that it dropped. I don't know what happened there. I don't even know if I'm seeing chat anymore. Let's see. I'll type in chat to see if anybody responds. So, I have a couple experiences that I read about dealing with kicking and such. It was not too long ago that I was in a group. We were running something. I want to say it was Spies in the House on EH. And pretty sure there was something in the LFM about it's in progress, we're zerging or moving fast or whatever. I thought there was some indication of what to expect in any case. You can look at, sorry. Dream dropped. Alright, just updating chat with what's going on. And this person joins the group and asks what house it's in. And I'm pretty sure, like I said, the LFM had the quest, which means you can look there and tell where it is, generally speaking. In this case, it was for sure that was correct. He basically had no idea what was going on. You could tell that we'd been in there for several minutes. I didn't remember to look at the last time I just did Spies in the House, but it's not a long quest at that level. If you're zerging it on EH, people know what they're doing, it doesn't take very long. So he was immediately booted out of the party. And, you know, I think that's fair enough in that instance. I think there was enough indicators that we were moving quickly. We were in the middle of combat, I think, when that happened. And, you know, we're on EH, so we're into epic levels. Somebody's had to play the game for a while. I think that wasn't uncalled for. I can see why you would do that as a party leader. Otherwise, we would have had to stop, wait for him to find it, wait for him to catch up, which is in the quest. If he doesn't know it, that's not a quest that you can just really start with. There's the swim, there's the traps, there's the Marioing part. I mean, you know, it's a Zerg group. We're not going to wait. If you want to step in as we're finished and do it yourself, fine. We may have been repeating it, I don't remember. But, you know, in that case, that person, I think, was wasting other people's time. He shouldn't have been trying to get in that group in the first place. I don't disagree
You
with it.
stand amidst a scene of terrible slaughter. The inevitable has already passed this way.
I'm glad you can see it. So, yeah, that's my opinion about that particular case. Other cases I've seen where I don't think it was really
You
warranted.
see signs of ancient architecture.
I get irritated with people as well. You know, they don't say hi to the group. They just come in and say share which house. Most of the time when I group, when I pug, I should say, I either know where the quest entrance is and know how long it's going to take me to get there, or I'm standing outside of it when I join. Because face it, there aren't enough people to snap up the spots in most groups anymore, so it's not a big deal to run to the quest to make sure it's the right one. It's when you think it is, it's the right one. Figure out where it is before you join the group. I think that's just really good practice. It's different as a static group, or you know, it's your friends or guild mates or whatever. That's a different story, but for pugging, you know, you're joining their... you're joining their group, and you should treat it as such. You know, leaders control, they're doing what they're going to want to do. And, you know, you can always find a different group or start your own if you don't like the way they're handling it. That's always a fair option. I've seen some groups I would never join based on what's in their LFMs. Hello, Zero. Another time, I was in an EE group, which is rare for me. I don't usually EE, but there was a EE group that said, you know, all welcome kind of thing. And I said, okay, well, I know I'm really not going to be doing all that much, but at least I can probably help, you know, put some DPS, help kill stuff, try to stay alive. At the very least, try not to lead the death count. And we were doing pretty good, and this wizard comes in who was mid to high 20s. I don't remember exactly what level he was, but he had something like 232 hit points. If you have 232 hit points, I don't care what class you are, why are you in EE? That's just a drain on the party resources. I mean, I have, at the moment, near 1,000 hit points. And, yeah. I was dying. But he was there, and, you know, he helped as he could. He did buff us up a bit. And, he tried to kill stuff, but every time he did, he got aggro, and he got dead. And somebody had to raise him. And at some point, I think we just left him somewhere. Because he was just draining, and when we finished the quest, he got booted. Because that's just rude to everybody else in the group. To walk into a pug with 200 and some hit points and on E and expect the rest of us to carry you, not a good thing. All right, I lag right at the beholders. That's awesome. Oh, cool. Looks like next update, Temple of Elemental Evil. Thanks for the notice, and I'm sorry I can't read your name against the white background at the moment. Overvon. Hey, Titan. So I'm all for being friendly and helping people learn the game and stuff, but, I mean, if you're playing Epics, you should know at least some of the game by then, and you should know basic things, like not going into Epic Elite with 200 and some hit points, like know where to find some of the most often run quests in Epic to group with. If you don't, you know, take some time on your own and figure it out. If you see a group for something you don't know, go find where it is. Use your time. Not everybody else's to do that. That's my opinion on that stuff. I mean, if you're talking, you know, Korthos, that's a different story. Yes, people aren't going to know necessarily. But when you get to Epics, you should have played enough to know some of this stuff. And it's just common courtesy and common sense in some cases. Don't put the time of 5 other people ahead of yourself, or 11 other people if you're in a raid. And if you know you're going to be AFK for a bit, you expect the rest of us to carry you, don't have a the thing we need to progress the quest. Oh, I missed that jump because of lag. I haven't missed that in a while. I do not do well playing on the beta servers. So I don't preview stuff. I have in the past and I just don't enjoy it. I don't like resetting my progress, doing stuff for nothing. I don't see the point in playing where it doesn't count, basically. Chad is talking about the next update stuff. Trolls, don't keep me from my loot. You're gonna die anyway, but you better not keep me from my loot. Looks like the drow houses are what it's all about tonight on Thelanus, at least for open groups. Look at Lamania and such as, why would I want to play somewhere that doesn't count towards one of my characters progressing? So, that's why I don't do that. Plus it's the whole pain of installing a second copy of the client and all that junk, which, doesn't appeal to me. I'm good with the level cap being pushed back. I want to finish my ATRs first. I plan to do epic completionist on this character, so two less levels is fine with me. Yay, 40k wasted XP. Alright, that's done. Just typing in chat to make sure they can read it. In case the stream's being laggy and such, my voice is coming through like it should. So, Overvon talks about Temple of Elemental Evil and update 25 in the forums. Talk about 24 is Zorian Epic Pack, some kind of Dragon Cult for Realms quests, Barbarian changes and Healing End changes. Titan talks about the level cap 30 being pushed back again. Alright, back to whatever's going on the server. Another thing to do when you're in here, especially for things like Haywire, is make sure you grab your loot and take the quest again. Makes it easier. Souls is running tonight. I wonder what else he's going to run. You know, I'm going to go ahead and join them. Souls runs good parties, I believe, if I remember right. letting them know that I'm streaming. Turn.
As you emerge from the gulch, trollish war drums begin to beat a steady rhythm. You have been spotted by a lookout. The Blackheart trolls have made their
I'm still trying to read chat, so I'm not paying attention to where I'm going. That doesn't work well. Thin some of these guys out, so I don't alert if I can avoid it. Just making sure I manage alerts, as I don't want to have any ill effects on the rest of the party.
Ahead, a glowing barrier blocks access.
Awesome. Glad to hear it settled down. Hopefully it'll stay that way. Oh yeah, this is the guy that leaves the chests. I'm not going to stop for him. I'm too far behind anyway. Besides, really, only the end chest, the epic chest matters, right? Not getting anything out of the other chests. Pick up the collectible real quick, though.
This great hall is flanked by towering statues from a lost age. Vale chose a dramatic battleground for her last stand against the inevitable.
I'm running as fast as I can. Looks like Devil Assault and then Lords of Dust is what the plan is at the moment. Which is not at all surprising. The most frequently run, the most popular stuff. They're asking if they want me to wait. Which, because the leader asked, then I'm okay with. Waiting, making them wait. We're going to stick together as a group. That's cool. I'm trying to go as fast as I can and not delay. I have blinding speed on, so I shouldn't need to worry about movement bonuses for anything else. Crap, which way do I come out on this side? It's over here, isn't it? Usually go the other way. Go, go, go. There we go. And we're good. flanking everybody. Or chest that matters. Oh yeah, I turned off guild names because of the whole red guild name problem. It's easier to just not have them on than deal with that. Keeping trying to kill your people in your party because they have a guild name that's red, which is a great achievement, and I understand it's neat to have it in a different thing to show off, but it's really annoying. Again, welcome everyone. Thank you for watching. Hopefully the stream has settled down and is smooth again. We had some issues there for a while. It was getting choppy for no apparent reason. Hopefully that's all smoothed out. We're good to go now. On the screen should be the server I'm playing on, which is Thelanus. An email address, which is ddostreamqa7@seymourgo.com. In case you're watching this archived on YouTube or Twitch, non-real-time, non-streaming, you can send questions there, and I'll try to answer them the next time we stream. What else is on there? Oh, my channel, twitch.tv/seymourgo. I stream DDO and other things. Last Saturday did an 8-hour stream of DDO. I don't know what I'm doing this week. I'm trying to do one or two more days other than this regularly. My Twitch page has information on my Steam games list, which I have 1,100 and some games on there, any of which I can stream in theory. Link to my site where I post some thoughts and observations about DDO and streaming.
Stormreach guards huddle at their barricades.
I would appreciate it if you would follow DDO stream as well as my own channel. Give us more follows. Build this up to be better and better. Thanks to Cordovan for giving me the opportunity to stream on this channel. It's a fun thing to do. A little more community activity than I do sometimes. I end up being solo a lot. Just waiting for everybody to get here in Devil Assault, and we'll start this. I don't anticipate this taking very long. Each wave should be pretty much dead instantly with what we've got going on here. He says hello. Thanks to Blue Queen for another tweet updating the streaming status. Appreciate your help. Doing that, keep people informed of what's going on. Kind of hard to do sometimes while you're in-game playing. I was watching Grizzly's stream last week and trying to play him at the same time, and I couldn't keep track of both at the same time. I ended up having to watch his replay, and I stopped by his chat briefly, and then we were in the middle of Lords of Dust or something. I had to keep going and missed interacting with him. So hopefully this week I'll stop questing before his stream starts, or at least before I start watching, and be able to interact more. Because that is part of what a streaming is, right? It's the interactivity is part of it. It's not just watching someone else play, it's interacting with them. Thanks, Blue Queen. Appreciate it. Amazing how much faster these waves go down when there's other people in here. Out of curiosity. Got 462 heart seats, what I thought. Just trying to finish the last couple things I need to do before doing the ETR grind. And how many comms do I have? 2700. Yeah, I'm so glad they went to heart seeds for that. Oh, you want to see my weapon? Yeah, I can do that. It's a Thunderforged. I bought this off the auction house, Astrosard auction house, not too long ago. I'll show it again in a minute in case you didn't get it all. It came as is. Well, of course there's a lot of enhancements and such that affect it, but it came pretty much as is. With a Meteoric Star Ruby included, Epic Band of Dragons, Tier 1, plus 10, First Degree Burns. All that came with it when I bought it. The rest of the stuff, I put the Force Critical Ritual on it, bound and attuned it, and then the rest of the stuff is enhancements and Epic Destiny. And all that. Yeah, my damage went a lot higher with it. I'll show you my previous weapon. It was a chained soldier. Ooh, I can talk today. That one. Nope, that's the integrator. Where did the teenage soldier go? Well, I must have taken off my bar. I rearranged my bars after I finished my epic destinies, and I haven't quite got them where I want them yet. Looks like I missed one of my weapons. I still have it on here for backup, in case this one dies, I thought. Or I might have accidentally moved it in my bank. Looks like it's in my bank. I kept the antiques. That's what I'm working on. Huh, I thought I had that as a backup. Oh well, it's in my bank. It was a chain soldier great axe with two rubies. I bought it all in the regular auction house. I don't own Thunderhome or Haunted Halls, so I'm not VIP, so at the moment I can't, even if I wanted to, I can't get out there to do anything. I may do that at some point. My guild doesn't really do high-level stuff a lot. We group for a static group on Thursday nights, and then whenever some people are on, we may or may not run together. It just kind of depends on everybody's mood and what they want to do. So I don't really have a high-level raiding group that I do any high-level raids all the time or anything like that, or even regularly. So we don't. I haven't done several of the raids in game yet. I just did Master Artifice for the other day. Haven't done Lord of Blades yet. Still, I've seen a couple groups up, but I've been concentrating on doing other things and just didn't get into them. Hope they come back around, because I want to get the favor, if nothing else. Haven't done Abbott. Haven't done Tower of Despair. Haven't done Fall of Truth. There's a couple others out there, I think. Finally did Titan not too long ago. Let's see. Yeah, the Fire and Thunder Peak, Temple of Deathworm, Fall of Truth, Caught in the Web. Haven't done that. Tower of Despair. I'll concentrate on combat for a minute. Not that I really need to. As long as I'm swinging my axe somewhere close, it'll kill somebody. This character, let's see. Oh, the next wave's starting. No, no, it's just the ranger. Oh, hello. Huge lag. A leader of Shavarath steps through the portal to engage. A leader of Shavarath has fallen. That was quick. The battle may allow you a moment's rest. Alright. So while we're resting. So I'm pretty sure next time, now that I have this axe, and if I get the Epic Antique Great Axe, I'm going to take Pure Silver out. I had that because I didn't have anything with silver, and I was doing Devil Assault and other stuff a lot, and it just helped. I'll probably keep the first blood, I'll probably keep Binding Speed, probably keep Overrunning Critical, but I'll take something else in that place. Just a quick look at the rest of my feats while I'm in here. In case you're curious, I do have a character overview video both on YouTube and Twitch. If you want to see more detail about the character, I'm going to re-record it at some point and actually go over a little more. I have a friend who is interested in how DDO works and wants me to sort of run him through how it, so I'll probably just do both at the same time. I'll go over my character and how Epic Destinies and work and all that at the same time. I do that, I'll narrate it and all that. So it'll be a little more useful than the current one, which is pretty much silent. I was using it to test the streaming the first night I was streaming on DDO Stream, making sure everything was working because I hadn't streamed in a while. I record a lot. Haven't been streaming as much, so I'm going to make a shift at some point to streaming more and plain recording less, but my guildmates don't want me to stream our Thursday runs, and so, or post them publicly, so I don't do that. Respect their wishes on that. Or else I'd have a lot more content up, because we're going through every quest in the game on Elite, where possible, at level. We've had a couple misses, but mostly we're doing good at that.
Enemy reinforcements have arrived.
Did not drive as fast as I expected him to. There we go. Yeah, until I get the Boots of Innocent and respec a little bit, I do not have the DCs to actually do Stunning Blow or Trip very often, so I don't really use them much in Epics. I can land them sometimes on Normal, but that's about it. I've been primarily putting together gear set for running from 20 to 28 and not sitting at 28 doing endgame stuff, so that's one of the reasons I don't have a lot of that stuff. It hasn't really been my priority. Most of what I'm wearing now is either from running through Stormhorns on Saturday, or just random loot that I've gotten, soloing and pugging and such. I did craft my spyglass with Master's Gift in it, but last time Cove was here. That was my big goal for that and getting one of my other characters, a Flask of Rum, all the way up. Once I finished my Destinies, I went through and put together a level 20 gear set with what I had. Got rid of all the junk. I think I have some stuff to switch out to at 24. And I've got this 27, 28 stuff that I have on now. That's my quote endgame stuff. Or when I'm at here at Cap, I'll run with that. But it cleared up a lot of bank space and inventory space when I did that. I ran an inventory in a quest the other day and I was really annoyed. We were doing Whiz King. Two runs back to Bathic, and I had forgotten to clear my inventory before I went to the first one, so with the, five or six chests in there, it filled up pretty quick. At least at the end, plus the other ones you get. Yeah, there's a lot of chests in there. I had to pick and choose, and I'd rather just have inventory space and hit loot all. Go through it later. Most of it ends up going into the shared bank to move over to my other crafting character. My bank / crafting character, I should say. Hey Titan, I don't know if this group will have room for you. I'm running with this group through Lords of Dust next. Of course, the way this is going will be a pretty quick run. But if somebody drops, see if we can get a spot for you in here. Otherwise, after we get through Lords of Dust, then I'll drop this group and we can run through stuff like we did last week. Just pick some stuff and go.
As the wave of devils ebbs, a leader of Shabarat steps through the portal to engage.
I was talking to somebody the other day, Blue Queen, who either run with you or watched your stream. I don't remember what he said, but we were talking about streaming and such and how it's kind of annoying to have to, I'm on Thelanus, you're on Caneth, I think, Caneth or Kyber or something like that. And it'd be nice if we could all run together at some point, all the stream team. But that'd probably mean going to Iconics so that we could all be at some level together. Doesn't have to be regularly, just something different to So we're all in the same stream. In our own streams doing this something together. I think that'd be a neat thing to do. Have Quartervon run with us and everybody streaming on their own channels and see what happens. Bring DDO. Yeah, Titan, I did. I've got PDK Iconics on every server. I could just run one of those. Yeah, Kaneth. I thought it was that. Which, by the way, I do have... still have anniversary cards to trade on other servers if anybody's interested. The one major trade I had fell through and I didn't bother with any others. Obviously, I want them on Thalanus because that's where I play, but... I have a full, however long the event was, worth of cards on other servers too. I logged in most days to get the card, which was boring to log into every server and do that. Click, 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 click. Oh, I didn't realize your other thing was on Wayfinder. I thought it was still on Kaneth. Yeah, that whole starting over thing, which is why I really haven't played any other servers. I've done Favor Dashes, but that's about it. Because that was fairly quick and got me some decent points. This is where all the resources are, so this is what I play. Hello, Jim. Nice to see you back. See that? That's true. If y'all are normally on other servers, then going to one that nobody's on is a level playing field. Welcome to everybody who's watching again. Got some information on the stream this week, so it should be easier to tell what's going on, where I am, and who I am. I'm on Thalanus, playing Epics at the moment. We're in Devil Assault. My channel is switchtv.cmorgu. I stream other times and sometimes other games. Just started playing Binding of Isaac Rebirth today on my Vita. Haven't got a PS4 yet, or else I'd probably be streaming that. Sometime soon. since the save does transfer between Vita and PS4. It's convenient. I can at least start some unlocks on my Vita, and then when I get a PS4 I can stream whatever happens after that. I don't see myself playing enough to get good at speedrunning or anything like that, but it's a neat game. I enjoy that too. That's a pretty good representation of the servers there.
The assault has been quelled for now.
So we're going to start Lords of Dust on EH next. I think I got my loot out of that one. I'm getting a little bit of lag here, so I'm not exactly sure what's going on. Hey, my guild leveled up. That's awesome. We're up to 75 now. Ho ho ho. Somebody got a +3 to +4 int upgrade tome in their loot. We're doing the roll thing for the So we rolled for it, which is somebody else won. Congrats to Simon who got that tome. Yeah, guild level's awesome. Haven't seen that in a while. Demon's Blood, Token, Small Devil. Hey, that was a pretty good epic chest right there. Small Devil Scale, Small Glowing Arrowhead, Small Length of Internal Chain, Token of the 12, and Devil's Blood all in the same chest. Plus fragments, but who cares about those? We're doing the whole cell repair thing and then Lords of Dust. Oh, yeah, I'm going to get my reward and junk. I don't know, does anything unlock at 75 even? Hey Titan, Simon just logged off, so you might have a chance at coming in the party. If you still wanted to do that. We're about to head into Lords of Dust. Got it. It's kind of the point now where I run with the same people over and over and over again. Which is fine, because that gets me used to them and how they operate. It's interesting we happen to be on the same time a lot of times. Whoa. Inventory go away. Lords of Dust. Market. Someone just logged again, so Hungris just left, so we do have one spot again. always go that way. I think I remembered the other ways a little quicker. Are we all the way through this? Yeah, this looks like a Zerg. These being some of the ones that open. Groups are up fairly often. I run these, but I'm not really familiar with them. That's right, Titan, you said you were going skiing, didn't you? I don't really need the golden guy if anybody else wants it. No one. All right. Chill pervades all right. The lower level as the path leads down. It begins then I'll go ahead. Like a dark and sinister temple, and less like an empty warehouse. Thought I'd offer.
A woman's voice drifts up from somewhere below. She speaks Noman's name, and the Inquisitor himself replies.
You will do no such thing. The Silver Flame has caused enough trouble. Soon nothing I can say will throw them off the scent. No, you will stay here and see that no one gets by. I will go below and assist our guests.
Not sure exactly. Probably another hour or two, Titan. We'll see. I am probably going to take a break here shortly, though.
Inquisitor Noman stands next to a strangely confident-looking drow. They seem to be finishing some elaborate and unholy.
What? Surprised I am not who you thought I was? I should have killed you at the start. This is nothing, my friend, a nuisance. The ritual is underway, and the Silver Flame is powerless to stop it. So pray, shall we continue? Ooh.
Children, give to the glory of our cause.
Stand aside. Let my minions kill this filth.
Cultists. You sacrifice yourself for nothing. Technical difficulty.
The cat seems to bump my HDMI cable. So I can no longer see chat on the TV.
After the tape? Huh? You going after the tape?
You have entered the nether realm of Kyber. A magical barrier built by the Silver Flame glows on the path ahead.
Oh, there we go. Turn the TV off.
Dusty remains.
She's using the computer for chat.
Front of a sealed stone door on the far side of the room.
Go for the optional chests. Yes, no. Nope.
Hot,
yes,
stale
yes.
Air blows into the chamber as the stone door slides open.
No, it's locked. Can someone unlock? There's four of us standing at the chest.
The drow here are intently prying
somebody
dragon
got it.
Shards from the cavern wall.
Wouldn't have minded not getting it, considering it's junk, but it's okay. I'll take it. More stuff to deconstruct for crafting. I really don't know this quest. It's easy to get, for me to get lost in here, so I'm trying to stick with the group.
The passageway is eerily quiet.
Just a crest or something else back here? I don't remember. If everybody else is running back, it's probably just a crest. That was a nice stun. Yeah, I was in Wisconsin for a bit. It got pretty cold and there was lots of snow. It was an interesting difference. There is a mushroom down here for sure. I think that's it.
This magic barrier is different. It is flanked by a pair of empty sockets.
I know we are doing this next. I am going to take a very short, quick break.
The Fire Reaver Lord howls as his essence is scattered back into the lava from which he came.
Alright, back. It's a club of fire absorption and such.
Drow priestess is absorbed in an elaborate spell to counter the silver flame wards. A chasm filled with jagged rocks and sharpened stakes lies under a narrow path. One wrong step could prove deadly.
Make it. Now where am I? Got a couple places like that where you get stuck, you're not sure where you are. Well, I want to go back to Wisconsin and get some food. There's a Chinese place back there that I really love their egg rolls. Their wonton soup is amazing. Reasons to not be a fighter or melee in general, but I really enjoy not having to worry about casting my own buffs and managing my spell points and all that. Walk up to things and kill them. Very simple. Don't worry about running out of ammo or any of that. Just kill.
As the path drops deeper into the heart of Kyber.
Hey, Jim. Thanks. Appreciate it. Do caffeine anymore. I used to drink Dr. Pepper. I don't like coffee either. I usually, if I do something like that, it's tea. About that quite a lot. Still don't think I need I'll get back here, you stupid hound. Get back here and get dead. I find that caffeine really screws up my sleep schedule. In a bad way. Yeah, I need to read that post. I haven't seen it yet. Some scrolls dropping. At least for somebody. Things dying all around. Die, 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 die. Die, 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 die. I never really understood the shrines there. I guess it's to res. Seal of the Flame Ward. That's a nice drop. Couple of Darkstorm Helms as well. I don't need the seal at the moment. No, I really don't do anything like that. Skiing or snowboarding is the question in chat. On to Spinner of Shadows. EH. I got an email from Moby saying that there's a new album or something out.
Ahead, a Rakshasa and a company of drow.
Rakshasa, that's how you say that. Of dragon shards. I often have the sound lower off. Living with someone who works early in the morning and takes naps midday when I... midday or early evening. Means that sometimes I'm playing when she's napping, so...
Strange glowing spiders are locked in battle.
I often have the audio off. That, and just like any game audio, I find it annoying or repetitive fairly quickly after I hear it the first time. Like, oh no, the Sawagin found me. Things like that. They get old fast.
While below her, glowing the spiders consume the last of the flames. And you find yourself unable to move. The Spinner of Shadows has broken free. At last I am free from that disgusting flame.
I don't remember if Tell the Element Leave was the one I'm thinking of or not.
I see that you have brought me the dragon shards that she needs. Though I also see that you have allowed some pests to follow you inside.
The demon overlord glares down at you with contempt.
The stink of Eberron is on you, mortals. I will turn my attention to your world in due time, but for now...
And things like this, monologues that go on and on.
Someone must witness my return and survive.
I'll say the first time it was
destroy
neat.
Destroy these intruders, my lady!
One of the Rakshasas growls.
We will report your glorious release to the world. Now let us leave this place. You must help us release
hope the audio balance is good.
Overlords.
With the other talking going on here.
I will do no such thing. Now that I am free, I have no need for the other overlords. Or for you tedious lords of dust. Not when she awaits me. Now be gone!
A burst of blue flame suddenly erupts in front of the demon. The Spinner of Shadows screams and scuttles back into the darkness. You feel her grasp on you slip as the Silver Flame Guardian speaks.
Hold, demon. You have not escaped yet. Some of the flames.
Look forward to seeing what the DDO store sales are this year. And the Steam sales, of course.
The Silver Flame Guardian speaks.
We have driven her back, but it will not last. Destroy her spiders. They have consumed the essence of the Silver Flame that holds her here. If you can light the wards again, she will be imprisoned once more. Quickly now, she returns.
Found it easier just kill things and let other people pick them up.
Now, flame spirit. You are too weak to battle me yourself, so you use these mortals as pawns.
It's easier for only a couple people to keep track of how many they have and all that.
From our time together. No matter. Let us begin.
The voice of the silver flame whispers in your mind.
Many spiders have burrowed underground, yet they can feel the spinner's pain.
If Sierra 36, she should be dying very easily.
This is pointless, mortals. I'll not be imprisoned again.
A chorus of chittering echoes the spinner's cries.
Looking forward to a good sale on Evening Star and Thunderhome. I'll pick those up. Not sure what else could be good for me. Those are the two main ones. And we've got respawns.
Once more, the demon's voice echoes from the shadows above.
I know several Steam games I want to get, so I hope they're on sale. Crypt of the Necrodancer is one of them. Age of Wonder 3. There's a bunch of stuff on my wish list that I wouldn't mind having. But those ones that come to mind immediately when I think of holiday sales. Got an insane number of cards to deal with, too. Steam trading cards. For whatever they do for the holidays this year. Hopefully something interesting and fun. Makes some sort of sense, and I sort of cult worship way.
A feeling of dread overwhelms you, as if darkness.
Keep glancing over there and going, "Hey, look, there's spiders." No, it's just the tufts of those torches, whatever they're called. Again, hello to people who are watching. Welcome, if it's your first time, or welcome back if you've watched before. This is Seymour Gruon, the official DDO stream. I'm your community stream team member for tonight. I see the Blue Queen is in here, who is another stream team member. I am running on the DDO stream Tuesdays at 5 p.m. Eastern.
I am free, and I call to you. Come for me.
I know Blue Queen is on Saturdays and Mondays. I don't remember the time offhand. And I know Grizzly Noise, I think, is Wednesday afternoons. Cordovan has Wednesday lunchtime afternoons. I stream on my own channel, twitch.tv/Seymourgu. I haven't nailed down exact regular days and times yet. Kind of depends on my SO's work schedule. But I do plan on streaming regularly. Hopefully another day or two of the week besides this. There's an email address showing at the bottom of the screen, which is videostreamqa7@simorgo.com. If you're watching this on replay or don't feel like chatting at the moment and think of something you want to ask or talk about later, be happy to take that via the email address and then talk about it next stream if I can fit it in. Oh, I need to watch my health. Huh. I do archive videos both on Twitch and on YouTube. So you can check either my Twitch page or YouTube channels for more videos. Both streams and just straight recordings. I do both. I like the higher quality of recordings. I don't like the upload time and the space requirements, but they do turn out nice.
In the shadows.
An amusing game, mortals, but you are out of time. I grow stronger and your allies dwindle. We end it now.
Enough for all the torches, so they're lighting them now. Let's see. Some kiting going on. Let's see if I can get over here and help kill these guys. Crunch. Let's see. Yeah, no problem, Blue Queen. Oh, right, yeah, Titan. The Cordovan does two Wednesday things. He does the weekly lunchtime live stream, and then he does the static group.
She will be here soon.
No DDO guys stream sometime. I don't know what their slot is. I forget. I watched part of theirs this past week, but I don't remember when it was. Sundays, is it? Anyway, check the other members of the stream team out. The schedule is on the DDO stream page. With, I think, links to everybody's individual Twitch pages, so you can give everybody a follow and see when they stream other times besides on this official stream. No one else played with overhead health, huh? It's the only way I notice sometimes. And a lot of times I still don't notice. If you look at it, I've got health showing four places. I've got it, the big character bar, the bottom of my screen. I've got it in the party bar, the smaller character bar in the party bar. I've got it overhead, and then on my G13 gamepad, it's showing there as well.
The last ward ignites, and brilliant light fills the cavern. The Spinner of Shadows shouts, but it is a shout of triumph, not defeat. Once again, you are held in an irresistible web of force.
And now we watch the plot. At least there's always replay.
She's here. I called to her across the worlds, and now she is here. Your prisons and your wards mean nothing to her. Tremble,
I'm curious to see what the replay is going to look like for those first couple minutes of the whole Twitch thing being awkward. Hopefully it worked Got saved so I can upload it. Yeah. He was just going out for a walk. She just took him out. His nails on the hardwood floor is pretty audible.
I have, replies the Spinner of Shadows. The Drow brought them to me, just as you said they would. What shall I do with these irritating mortals?
Yep. That is another thing. If you play, actually play with Quarterman on his Wednesday, maybe Wednesday live stream, he gave out TP codes, which is nice. There is much to do. Yeah, he seems to be. Lolth's voice fades away. I've watched some of the streams live and others on archive. They all seem interesting groups, and Quarterman seems pleasant the entire time, which I don't know that I can be that pleasant the entire time in some of those groups. Don't know if I have that in me. I try. Let's see if anybody wants this. No takers for the Templar's Dock. Docent. Alright, I'll just grab it anyway then. Got the Charlotte Templar's Bulwark, which I think I needed. Oh, that's cool. I think we have one more quest left, don't we? On this chain. And then we'll be... I'll be out of this group. We have to do the actual... Oh, that's loud.
Mistress, the passage to Kyber remains open to your advantage. The Drow of the Underdark will not fail you. Woe to the intruders who dare enter the demon web. They will be slaughtered as a sacrifice to your greatness. Even that fool Elminster will not hinder the darkening that will consume Toril. Nothing will stand in your way.
There you have the plot. In case you're wondering what's going on. Oh, souls left. There's a spot, Titan. Yeah, the little bit of video in here is way beyond what the normal engine looks like. I really wish accommodations would just go into your bag. I got plenty of inventory space, I can go ahead and go. Buffs? I like buffs. I'll take buffs. Oh, the dog has energy.
Take heed, friend. Stranger here, I'm thinking. What brings ye into the demon web? Ye must have come through the rift that she made. The rift to the other world. Perhaps ye have come to mend it.
I swear that
no small task. I can aid ye in all this, but
yeah, he did.
Not be easy. Come with me.
He said he had a phone call or something. Dog parkours off the couch sometimes. He's running so fast, he jumps and does a turn on the back of the couch and comes back
out. It's so
interesting to watch.
It was only possible for me to come here because Lorth let her guard slip when the rift opened. And I cannot easily leave the demon web until she slips again. This rift, her sister, the magic shards she's plundered from your world. They are all part of some
Before
you. Closer to my home, Lorth now wages war on the kingdom of Cormyr in a little village named Evening Star. This rift and that war
bound together in her
plan. And so are you, I suspect. The hunched creatures ahead make some... Hark! I sense that she has dropped a guard again. Occupied with her sister, most like. I must leave when I can. Find my way to Evening Star. I will meet you there. It is a dangerous journey, but... you seem to be accustomed to...
Yeah, that's kind of a horse in the background, that's the dangerous journeys. Sounds like he's galloping like a horse. Titan, send me a towel and I'll get you in here. There we go. Let's do it that way. Easier. All right. I think I've only done one of the other demon web quests. I need to get back to that and do the explorers and figure that stuff out a little more.
Only the strong survive in the demon web.
I remember spending a frustrating hour just getting to one quest. I don't really like going in there. And I always follow people in here, I don't know where I'm going. Haven't got the route down yet. Get back with chat in a minute. I know I'm falling behind. But I said I'm trying to keep up with the group. This other computer is set at an angle. It's a bit rough to lean over and do that while not falling off a demon web.
The spinner of shadows scuttles along the demon web, intent on some errand of her own.
We have combat. I can just swing my axe and not have to move a bit. I can look. I agree. Elminster's this really powerful wizard. He's meddling in all these things with gods and everybody. And he can't be bothered to help.
The brood it bore has already consumed the weak and the slow. Then
a random group get through the
fight for its survival.
Demon web at all? Come on.
Forgotten worlds gods lie in snare.
If it's so important that this be done, shouldn't he be helping?
This will be the fate of Eberron, unless you find a way to prepare the
I never understood that really about adventuring in general, DDO and stuff. But even pen and paper. Like, okay, you have this really big problem and you trust some random strangers who walk up to handle it for you? Are you sure that's the best idea? Sure that's the best thing for your city, town, village, country, whatever? In some cases, you know, if it's like this against the wolf, okay, send the people we don't know how to die, I understand that part, but a lot of these are, you know, like, oh, I have a gambling, there's a gambling problem in town, why don't you take care of it for me so I don't have to, what? Well, why don't you do that? Don't understand why you'd trust just random people to do that for you.
On a distant shard of the demon web, Loth greets the Spitter of Shadows.
It is time, my sister.
Yeah, Coil. That would be awesome if you could knock the Elemister out. You can, Coil. This is our web, buddy. We did this. You stay out of it, like you're going to anyway. Yeah, and Coil. Oh. There's a comedy bit from Bombatom I think of when I picture things like Quail or even some of the hirelings about, I'm helping! No, you're not. You're really not helping. The moment. Yeah, I'll probably run that again to get another mantle. Put together another master's gift for lower levels. Door lag.
But at least it will take you away from the demon web.
DDO is so advanced it has different kinds of lag.
You find yourself in a vast cavern of stone deep below the surface. If you are to find Elminster, you must first make your escape from the vastness of the underground.
I don't understand the death jump spiders because they don't really jump that much. I expect them to jump on you from above, knock you down, make things a little more interesting than just a different name of normal spiders that scuttle around and once in a while jump on you. I mean, death jump, that sounds like, you know, something from MechWarrior, death from above. Ah, ham. Yeah. I haven't been around that long. I started after it went free to play, I think, so whatever. I keep meaning to look that up. I think in your account details, It shows you when you joined. I'm gonna look that up and see what when I joined, because I really don't remember. I know I joined and didn't play very long, and then came back and decided, yeah, let's give this another try, and enjoyed it better that time. And left again for a while, and came back, and then Cove. Wore myself on Cove. Left, came back. And then left just before the enhancement pass and came back. That was my longest break. It was almost 2 years. Everybody jump lag. Synchronized jump lagging. That's cool. Get a 4.6 from the Eastern Block Judge. Spell wards, as if traps weren't annoying enough.
You have stumbled into a group of heavily armed drow. They don't look anything like the drow you've encountered back in Eberron. And they also don't look pleased to see you.
I think it's funny that Ham still drops now and then.
Scouts are talking on the ledge above. Perhaps they can lead you up to the surface.
Perhaps they can, or maybe they don't know what they're doing. Maybe they're lost.
It will take you closer to the
surface. Going the wrong way.
The drow patrol you saw before is taking a break on the other side of the river.
Yeah, I thought it was interesting. I was getting tumble buffs the other day, and I was confused.
Above,
jump casting still doesn't make sense
you.
To me, but surface I do it. Here, I know it helps, but that's an immersion breaking thing. Why is it better to jump while you're casting? Shouldn't you be concentrating on casting? Oh. Look, we have some armors to kill. Of course, do they trigger spell wards? Huh. I say they don't trigger spell wards, I wish that armor did. Until recently, I never blocked, never tumbled. I stuck with the point and tumble because that was the build wisdom, right? So I still did that, but never used it. Was until I started playing my RD where I'm like, yeah, you know what? I really need to map my rune arm and
stand guard in front of the gate.
Block to something. I use my gamepad for WASD directional movement, but I also use it for a lot of the utility stuff, like mapping and such. It's like having that right at my fingertips. I don't use it for combat very much. That's what I have my mouse for. Naga Epic 12, well, what is it, 15 button mouse? 12 on the side, though. That's where I'm at. One of my bars, and then a couple extra bits, too.
These drow fought with military precision unheard of. Even the Even so, the defender of the outpost is finally dead.
Which works pretty well for a fighter. Not so much for a caster or anything else that has a bunch of abilities or spells to use. Doesn't really have enough stuff for that. I can see that, because I know I've seen you perch in different places and have something that that's blocking you that you're getting around so you don't take as much damage and such, so I understand that part of it.
A fresh breeze blows down from an opening in the ceiling. You've reached the surface, but the leader of the drow turns to confront you.
More fodder for the slave pits. Seize them!
Not much crown. Crown. Other than that, that'd be interesting at least. Not sure something I want to do. It's possible.
Anxiously point to a large lever near the door.
Thank the gods, I'd almost given up hope. But where did you come from?
Well, we had a disconnection. He's reconnecting, so we'll give him a chance to catch up. You know, if I move this chat window over here, I'll probably read it better. Hey, look at that. Oh, he's way back there. Seeing if he wants to. Okay, he's okay with us completing, so we're gonna go ahead and do that. Now we have to talk to the jerk who left us to wander around the demon web on our own. I need to bring my sorcerer back out. I haven't played that character in a while. Blah, blah, blah. Elminster, give me my accommodations. Thank you. And the bank's on this side, is it? Go throw some stuff in there. Yeah, bank space is on sale, so I went ahead and upgraded my... I have 90 slots now, which still isn't enough sometimes. So much loot! And my personal bank's 100. So much loot. These... Count. I don't have anything. I don't have anything else in that level range that's going to be making any use of it, so I'll just sell that stuff. It's useless for crafting. And what do I have here? I need jewelry. Let me haggle you a bit. There we go. Oh, we're in instance two. That's why there's nothing in the shops. I was wondering why there's so little in the shops. Because in the other instance, disrespect instance one if I actually want to buy anything. And these are all junk. Yeah, I've had to clear out several times. There's so much stuff. But I might use that someday on my 24th life and or on this alt character that I've played once or oh, Belly of the Beast, that sounds like fun. I don't know how to get there though. The other problem is I have stuff for every character class on every character. Yeah. It's easy to just keep collecting. That's why I'm trying to get my level 20 to 24 stuff set. And then my level 24 to 27-ish set. And then my level 27, 28 set. So I have all that figured out. Yeah, I've got 15 of 13 accounts, all of which have stuff stored, I think. Stuff in their bank for other characters. I need to do some way of figuring that out. I would really like, as been talked about in the forums, some way of just dumping all your characters' inventory so you can... Alright, then there were three. Yeah. I would love to be able to browse my character inventory on a phone or tablet. That would be nice. Don't really want to do Druid Chain. I do that all the time. Is there any other type anymore besides Google spreadsheets? Okay, they haven't started yet. I'm already in a group, so I'm going to leave that group, jump over to this group, and try to head towards the airship at the same time. I know I've grouped with them before. I used to be worse, but I've come to appreciate being able to run several quests in a row without having to empty my inventory after every one. And we're going to Vaughn 1, so it's better to take the airship exit than the teleporter. That will put us right where we need to be. I'll make sure before I say that. That is the case, yes. Skunk wins the hoarder contest with 18 mules, 6 dummy accounts, max inventory, and shared bank. That's the winner. There's so much loot to be had. I saw a post by somebody that, has 4 guilds that were active at one time and now defunct, but he keeps the airships around for the guild chests to store stuff in. I was just reading that today on the forums, I think. Visiting past some of this, or running or visiting past most of this. When I do this anymore, I've gotten to be a big fan of doing that. I didn't used to be, but then again, I didn't used to have the Invis Cloak, which meant I had to keep potions on hand, which I'm not good about doing. So, we gonna kill this person over here? No. We're doing the non-killing talk. Yeah, I keep stuff depending on what I'm looking for. If it's cursed with slots, that's really good for crafting low-level stuff. If it just fits a hole I know I have in gear on a character, good combination. Con and false life, fortification by itself, speed by itself, that's maxed at a level with craftsmanship and all that. Just anything that I might need, although any more that speed and fortification pretty much comes through every time with just loot gen. It's the first time I have an it's the first time I've ever found that named item, I probably will keep it, at least for a while, until I figure out if it fills a need in one of my characters or not. I've gotten better about realizing that some of that stuff I know I can get again if I need to, so I've got it once. It's not that hard to get again. I know where it drops. If I really need it again, I can do that. Especially in something like in the Druid's Chain that I've been running nearly every day for a while. Let me check my ingredients, see if I can build another green steel thing. I don't remember what I'm down to now. I think it's smoke, maybe, that I haven't done yet. Yeah, because I don't think I have a displacement clicky at all yet. So that would probably be the next thing I'm going to do. Get a panic button. Stop heading away. Oh yeah, I haven't used any of my loot ups or XP boosts or any of that from my daily rolls or free from the thing, store, any of that stuff. I've kept all that around. I did use the crafting boost stuff when I was leveling my crafter up a bit. I think I bought Blade Forge, but I haven't ran one yet. I'm always conservative with potions and scrolls and such like, so things that are affect things like loot gen and XP, I want to make sure I use them at the right time, which means I never use them because they always sit in the bank until I remember to pull them out for the right time, which I don't. Just before a big raid with a bunch of chests or something like that, sure, it's a great time to pull one of those out if I would ever remember to do it. And right now the two things I'm playing are my epic character who has max XP at the moment, while I keep farming for the items I want for my epic TRs, and my static group character, which everybody else is a second or third lifer, and I'm a first lifer, so I don't need the XP there. Yeah, just don't see the use for it at the moment. I'm not really doing anything where it would make anything any better.
Gatemaster Gropes shrieks. You notice words etched above this gate. Ready room one. Inside, scarred and muscular trolls wait restlessly.
Are we going to go ahead and do this? Yeah, we are. Yeah, it's kind of what I'm keeping the XP stuff for mainly is the, if I ever do heroic TRs, then yeah, I'm gonna need it there. Even then, I'm probably gonna do iconics for most of them. I've got 15 characters, most of which I have run through Korthos and Harbor and Waterworks and all that stuff several times. I'm kind of looking forward to the epification of all that stuff to bring some new life to it. Because otherwise, I don't see myself going back there. Unless it's just for a favor run or something. At some point I'll learn Giant Hold, and at some point I'll learn Stormhorns and all that. Do more other stuff, but I tend to stick to the stuff I know and I'm comfortable with, really. Whoa! What the heck? That's not usual. I'm still hitting things for damage, that's funny. I hit for 100 and something after I died. What killed me? Yes, thank you. I would love to have a res. I have to pay more attention to what I'm doing. I was not evidently paying enough attention. I am probably going to be done in about a half hour for tonight. Except for Thursdays when I'm sure I will not be streaming. I will be streaming on random other days until I settle into a pattern. And depending on the SO schedule. Oh, Queen.
Their luck has run out. The Horns of Fury and the Maelstrom Princes have slain hundreds of their kind.
This is the shortest fight we've ever seen. Let the slaughter begin.
That's good timing then. By the time I wrap up, you all will be starting. Can you explain to me the attraction of that game? Because I've watched a couple streamers and I don't get it. Is it triggering the next step when these guys aren't dead yet?
It's time for an all-out showdown. Fresh fighters from all four teams have armed themselves for battle.
Ha 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 ha. Don't cross the streams. Stuff's coming in. Let's get this stuff killed. If I could focus on somebody that's at one at a time, because lag is being a little annoying here. Whoa, what the hell? Again? What the heck? Why is my health suddenly going to nothing? I've got Deathblock on. Wow. This usually isn't this rough. I don't know what's going on. Oh, Titan died too. So, three of us died. Something is hitting us harder than usual. I don't know what it is. Combat log's scrolling too fat. By too fast to check it, what it was. I do know that these shamans aren't dead like they should be. What the heck? Alright, blinded. That's awesome. It's another thing I haven't fit on my build yet is remove blindness. Or, blindness immunity. Not remove immunity. Was annoying. Finally.
Now is your chance to seize the mighty axe.
I've seen from retweets from Bill Murray. They're amusing. Some stacks of vulnerability, dude. Did he just heal all the way up? Why are his hit points jumping up and down so... What the... I don't know if that's visible to anybody else, but his hit points are jumping up and down. That was bizarre. This is going to be the last bit of this for today. I can probably go a little longer, but not too much. I really want to do Vaughn 2 and 4. I've already done 3 twice. I don't really care about that, so I might bow out about that time. Amusing. Are we clearing all the dudes out? We've already got Conquest. We've got most of Vandal. Way too many deaths. Oh, we're on EE, that's why. I didn't realize we were on EE. That went really well for EE. Thought we were on EH. Ugh. That's pretty amusing. I didn't pay attention to difficulty, and I wondered why I was dying. Oh, I don't think I've done all these yet. I love how many commendations you get on EE, though. Yep, it does say elite. I just wasn't paying attention enough. Would have been a little more cautious. Oh, and you know what? The other thing is, I'm wearing the wrong stupid helmet. I hate when I do that. Hard. Yeah, that's a good idea. I'm gonna go repair real quick. And people use their Twitters to advertise their streams and such. I keep my stuff private. I don't really post much. Favorite and retweet, but don't really post much. Maybe if I stream more, I'll use it as another alert system. I'm still fairly new to streaming. Okay, we're going to 1-2, presumably. Which is Von 2. Too much input. Yeah, I follow a lot of people and I mute a lot of people. It's the only way I can keep sane. I mute and unmute people as I want to see what they're talking about and don't want to see what they're talking about. Without affecting the actual follow. It helps to cut it down to something manageable at times. We'll see how long Vaughn 2 takes. It might be the last one I run tonight. I am getting fuzzy. I think I've been up since 4:30, 5, something like that. Nobody? Golden locket acquired. This should be interesting. Yeah. I don't remember because I never saw the remake, so. It's like the Highlander movies. There should be only one. There is only one, as far as I'm concerned. It's really campy. It's really 80s bad sort of thing, but it's also what it is, and it's good enough the way it is that they shouldn't touch it. They shouldn't have made any more of them. So is that an EE thing that mobs heal themselves so they don't take enough damage? The hounds in here are doing the same thing that dude was doing in the arena. I don't remember seeing that before. Say I love the original, but I enjoy the original. I still have issues with it, but it's not horrible. This is bad. Traps and lag do not mix well. Go this way. Oh, hello. Force trap. That was a bit of lightning. That hurt quite a bit. Wow, this new gear really helped. I'm not fully geared still, but it did make a difference. I could go find the other thing, but I get lost in this maze fairly easily. Hey, look, it's open. We're in the last probably 10-15 minutes of the stream for tonight for me. So I want to thank everybody for watching, joining chat, playing, had fun. Hope you all enjoyed it. See you again next week. And if you follow my channel, you'll be notified if I run it other times, which I'm planning on doing. Maybe other games, we'll see how it goes, see what I feel like. Also check out the rest of the community stream team. The Blue Queen here is going to be streaming in a couple minutes around the time the stream ends. Follow you, DDO stream, follow me, follow Blue Queen, follow Grizzly Noise, follow DDO guys, check out our YouTube channels and websites and Twitters and all the fun stuff. We have fun playing DDO and other games. Hope you guys do too. And if you feel like streaming, send an email to Cordovan and see about fitting in the schedule somewhere. As I understand, there's still openings for more people. So keep that in mind. It's something you feel like you want to do. Ah, that was a big hit. Oh, I didn't realize our rest was already dead. He's almost dead. Alright, I need to get out of his line of sight. Oh, freak. Did I not get it? I got it. Alright, time to go full healing. It doesn't do much, but it does something. All on different timers. Alright, back to the Great Axe. There. Somebody's keeping us alive somehow. Yeah, the way this is going, this will probably be the last one. So don't expect too much after the next 10 or so minutes. I made that starting soon screen. I did not make an ending screen. But that's fine. I suppose we could do a Blue Queen raid after this. The healer with the aura. Very good idea. Yeah, come at us one at a time. It's much easier to handle. Go this way then. Oh, if there's one thing I hate, it's face spiders. Quarry stalkers, whatever they're called. Might see if I can get my SO to join next week and see if we can get some different stuff going on. Lower level quests and all that. We'll be playing 16s if we do that. Although I tend to have a lot more fun in Epic. At this point I've been playing Epic mostly nonstop for a couple months, and I think sometimes, you know, a break would be a good thing. Is a pain to get. I've been caught too many times in here to do doubles on everything. seems like it's the right timing. I'll try one, but I don't know how they didn't get caught there. And I keep reading stone skin. Not used to having that clicky still. All the buffs. Give me all the buffs. I want them all. Every single buff. Buffs are good. Buffs are grand. I love me some buffs. Again? Ah, so it looks like Twitch is behaving badly again. At this point, it's at the end of my stream, so I'm not as concerned. I hope it settles down for me and everybody else that are going to be streaming in the near future. Make sure we're all up here for this.
Green ichor drips down from the branches above your head.
Oh, if you're gonna kite mostly, then I'm not gonna take the wear on my great axe. Thank you. That's what I was looking for. Kill the weakest one. Almost got him. This should just be about the right timing. And I love this jump without being able to see. Oh yeah, especially with the lag there, that's awesome. And now we jump down anyway. Locket sitting on the ground. There you go. Let's do this. Yeah. I agree. It's not horrible, it's just annoying. here and there, and we're trying to do things like Mario something, or click on the one thing you need to click on. Yeah, those also hit. Greater didn't happen. Then we can do the other chests. Are we just doing this chest? We are doing the other chest. All right. Somebody's doing it, maybe. Alright, I'm going to wrap it up as soon as we get this last chest. Y'all don't need to see me going back to the airship and repairing and all that. So, thank you everybody for watching once again. Like, follow, comment, discuss, and I will definitely see you next week. And as I'm understanding, the Blue Queen, who is in the channel right now, is going to be starting streaming, not DDO, but shortly. So have a good night, or day, or afternoon, or evening, or early morning, whatever the time is where you are. And I will see you next week or on another stream. Thanks a lot, everybody.